Shame on you.
But for Twitter.
Yeah.
But for Facebook. Well, and you look at an amazing, and we're going to talk about it a little later on today. The New York Times had a story yesterday talking about people were tweeting about health and tweeting about mindfulness and tweeting about, I don't know, flowers and music. And then they stumbled onto some of these conspiracy theories. And because Facebook's algorithms were set up to cause this sort of radicalism to explode, guess what happened? Their likes exploded, the people following them exploded. So you actually had Facebook and Twitter set up their business models in a way that would lead to the insurrection against the United States of America. It is on them.
But Joe, it's also the cable outlets, Fox Business, the new ones, who promulgated lies repeatedly every day. And we'll get to this, but some of the hosts are being forced to apologize for lying to their viewers.
Well, because they're being sued for all the lies about these, you know, Dominion and other vote counting machines. Just bold-faced lies. And they knew they were lying all along. They knew they were lying to their viewers and spreading the lie to try to get a couple of more thousand viewers. And it's landed them in last place now. I wonder if they're glad that they lied for the last several months and put American democracy at risk. Because in the end, not a happy ending for
them. This is how much our democracy was at risk. There is new footage from inside the Capitol on the attack as rioters brawl with police, storm the building, and rummage through documents on the Senate floor. Meanwhile, the Washington Post reports that Vice President Mike Pence wasn't rushed out of the Senate chamber until about 14 minutes after the first report of an attempted breach. Three sources tell the Post that if the attackers had arrived in the chamber seconds earlier, they would have been in eyesight of the vice president.
And they were going around screaming,
hang, they had a noose.
Hang the vice president.
They brought a noose to the Capitol.
Because Donald Trump was the one inciting them against the vice president of the United States. And of course, Mickey, you know that even though Mike Pence, his wife and his children were trapped in the Capitol building, while the rioters were going around screaming for Mike Pence's head, Trump never called him, never checked on him, never did anything to try to protect Mike Pence and his family. That shows you, again, the state of this guy's mind. While the rioting was going on, he wanted people to be hurt and he wanted people to be killed. That, I don't know what other conclusion you draw for that when he knows he incites people against a vice president.
He doesn't try and stop it.
He's gleeful at the violence he's seeing on TV, according to Mike Pence and others who were around Donald Trump at the time. He knew his vice president's life was in danger, and he did nothing about it.